Hi, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this tutorial, we will talk about the cultivation process of chili crop. Chili has different names in different languages. In Hindi, it is called mirchi. The botanical name of chili is Capsicum annuum and it belongs to the family Solanaceae. Chili can be had as a vegetable or it can be used to add flavor to your food in the form of spice. It is also used to make sauces and pickles. Red chili powder enhances the taste of your curries. The chili plant might grow to a height of 2 feet to 4 feet. Chili crop can be cultivated best in warm and humid climate. Subtropical regions are most suitable for the growth of chili crop. The ideal temperature for chili crop cultivation ranges from 25 degrees centigrade to 30 degrees centigrade. Let us now see the stages involved in the cultivation process of chili crop. The stages are land preparation, drip irrigation arrangement, seed sowing and raising nursery, transplantation, weeding and intercultural operations, pest and disease management, flowering and fruit formation, and harvesting. Let us now see how the land is prepared for the cultivation of chili crop. Let us now see how to prepare land for chili crop cultivation. Well-drained loamy soils, rich in organic matter with pH range 6.5 to 7.5 are best suitable for cultivation of chili crop. The soil should be ploughed to attain a reasonable depth of 10 to 20 cm with varying cloth sizes. The land is prepared by giving 2 to 3 ploughings and clod crushing after each ploughing. Disc plough or chisel plough can be used for ploughing. To 150 quintals of compost or farmyard manure should be spread and mixed well in the soil. Apply 2 kgs per hectare of azospirillum and 2 kgs per hectare of phosphobacteria by mixing with 20 kgs of farmyard manure. The land is leveled by using clod crusher after each fertilizer application for proper incorporation of fertilizer. Land preparation is now complete. Let us now see the arrangement of drip irrigation in the field. Drip irrigation saves water and fertilizer by allowing water to drip slowly to the roots of plants, either onto the soil surface or directly into the root zone. Through a network of valves, pipes, tubing and emitters. Overhead irrigation wets the plants but produces runoff. In contrast, drip irrigation is a much more controlled irrigation method. It works by exposing the roots to a direct supply of water. Drip irrigation system releases water in a slow and steady fashion and controlled amount of water is supplied to the plants at regular intervals. Let us now see the seed sowing and raising nursery for seedling growing. Mix sterilized cocoa peat along with neem cake and phosphobacteria for filling throw trays. Sow the treated seed in throw trays at 1 seed per cell.
The seed rate required per 1 hectare is 1 kg. The suitable months for seed sowing is June and July. Cover the seeds with cocoa peat and keep the trays one above the other and cover with a polythene sheet till the germination starts. After 5 days of sowing, place the pro trays with germinated seedlings individually on the raised beds inside the shade net. Water with hose pipe or rose can every day for seed germination. Drench with 19:19:19 at 18 days after sowing. At 25 days age, seedlings are ready for transplantation. The seedlings will be transplanted to an irrigated field. Seedlings are transplanted by hand or machine into moist and well-prepared soil. Make sure that the roots of the seedlings are completely covered with soil. Irrigate the plants immediately after transplanting to make the soil around the plant firm. The spacing required for varieties is 60:45 cm and for hybrids it is 75:60 cm. This reduces the competition between the plants and produces better yield. Let us allow the crop to grow by providing irrigation, and after that let us see how to do intercultural operations in the field. The crop production is adversely affected by weeds. They reduce yield, quality and marketability of vegetables. Weed infestation increases cost of cultivation. Some weeds provide hiding place for insect pests and act as host plants for pathogens. They block the drainage and impede the flow of water in irrigation channels. At 25 to 30 days, after transplanting respectively one intercultivation with blade harrow followed by line weeding within the rows is necessary. Subsequent intercultures at 10 to 12 days intervals till full coverage of land by crop should be given. If the crop is transplanted on ridges as irrigated crop, the weeding that is invariably required is by 3 to 4 days after each irrigation, preferably with a hand hoe. We will now talk about pest and disease management in the cultivation process of chili crop. The major insect pest attacks are caused by fruit borers, thrips, aphids, and yellow Moroni mites. The major diseases that attack chili crops are damping off, leaf spot, powdery mildew, dieback, fruit rot, and anthracnose. To control fruit borers, spraying pesticide fipronil is required. Thrips can be controlled by spraying insecticide dimethoate. To control aphids, spraying pesticide imidacloprid is required. Yellow Moroni mite can be controlled by spraying insecticide quinalfos. To control damping off, spraying of copper oxychloride is required. Leaf spot can be controlled by spraying mancozeb. To control powdery mildew, spraying vegetable sulfur is required. Dieback and fruit rot can be controlled by spraying copper oxychloride. To control anthracnose, spraying of mancozeb is suggested. We will now talk about the flowering and fruit formation of chili crop. As chili plants begin to mature, they start flowering. we will notice the flowers appearing on plants. This indicates that it is time to welcome the first set of chilies. All that stands between flowers and fresh chili pods is pollination. Pollination is taken care of naturally by bees and other insects. Generally, the vast majority of chili plant crop will be from self-pollinated flowers. Once chili fruits grow in size and color, the fruits are ready for harvesting. The time for chili harvesting depends upon the purpose and is done by picking the fruits. Picking of green chilies starts from 90 days after transplanting. Picking of dry chilies starts from 120 days after transplanting. We will now see the harvesting of green colored fully developed chilies. Chilies are harvested at 10 days interval. Fresh chilies are packed and sent to market immediately. Harvesting continues for up to 3 months. As discussed earlier, harvesting of red chilies starts 120 days after transplanting. It is done at 10 to 15 days interval for 3 to 4 times in case of rain-fed crop and for 5 to 6 times in case of irrigated crop. The dry chilies are picked along with stalk. The average yield of green chilies is 80 to 100 quintals per hectare and the average yield of dry red chilies is 15 to 20 quintals per hectare.
Thank you for watching our tutorial on the cultivation process of chili crop. Stay connected with tutorialspoint.com to watch our next tutorial on the cultivation process of a different crop.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.